Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the newly resurrected Lando Lakes Road to Glory series here in NCAA 14. Yes, NCAA Football 14 on the Xbox 360, the latest and greatest, if you will, in college football games, because they have not made one since. I'm not holding out hope for another. You never know. It could happen, but lots of things would have to go the right way for us to get a new next-gen football game. Certain player likeness lawsuits would have to break the right way and be appealed and all that. EA would have to be interested. The NCAA would have to be interested. There's a lot of things that would have to happen. So, like I said, I'm not holding my breath, but Lando Lakes on the field here against Washington today. Second game of the season for number 23, Stanford. And you see a five-yard run there. On second and five, he gets the ball again, puts that left shoulder into the defender and fights close to a first down. And oh, he might have hurt that left shoulder as he's holding something down on the ground. He's actually going to miss a little time as he's dinged up. He will be back in the game, though. Let's fast forward this thing to when he gets back in. It's still the first quarter, and they've got the football at their own six-yard line or so. He's going to get a nice run right there and get a first down. Seven-yard run for Lando Lakes. And they move the chains, getting out of the shadow of their own end zone. Never want to be back there and have the risk of taking a safety or anything. Second and 12 now, handoff to the right side. And he kind of runs into his tackle right there and goes down. Or maybe that was a tight end. I don't know. He's wearing 98. Kind of an odd number for whoever that is out there. So we got a third and nine play. Throw is over the middle and caught. There you go. Charles Mitchell connecting to whoever the receiver is right there for a first down. And now we get to run Lando again. Trying inside. He'll get 4 yards. And that'll bring up second and six. Stanford gets a first down. A breather for Lando Lakes. And he's back in the game on second and five. Looking to catch a pass himself. First down. And he's down to the 35-yard line almost on this catch. 17 yards. Let's watch it again. As he's set up on a linebacker, he says, I'll take this, get my first down. Always fighting for that extra yard. And he's got 17 total. Good for a first down for the Cardinal offense. So on first and 10, 54 seconds left in the first quarter. Running straight forward, bulldozing his way to 8 yards. It'll be second and two after the result of that Lando Lakes run. Later in the drive, second and eight. This will be another hand up to Lando. It gets 4 yards right there. It's positive. It's moving forward. Not big running plays yet in this game, but getting it done. Third and four. And he calls for the ball, and he drops it. Oh, would he have the first down? Probably. We won't know because he dropped the football, and they're going to have to kick a field goal here. Washington answers with a touchdown and leads it 7-3. Second quarter. Here is a screen pass. Nice block out front. Lando's got some room. He shoves a guy down. Did you see that stiff arm? Holy smokes. He goes 30 yards total on the screen. Let's watch it again. There was a vicious little toss away here. A little stiff arm. Let's watch it right there. Shoves him down and keeps going. Yeah, good center of balance on this guy. He's built sturdy. And you can't really take him down with arm tackles. Absolutely not. Not going to happen. First and 10. This ball is going to be thrown for a first down for Stanford. And they continue to move into Husky territory. Second and 10. Hand off to the right side. There's some room right there. He's going to get another 8 yard gain. And it'll be third and two. Watch a replay here quickly as he tries to get outside the tackle. And does so to the tune of 8 yards. All right, he needs a breather. He comes off the field. Stanford will score a touchdown, but so will Washington. They answer right back, and they've got the lead 14-10. Okay, our defense not exactly stellar to this point. This ball is going to be caught for a big first down with 50 seconds left in the half. Charles Alvarez strikes again, but can they get down the field to at least get some points? Well, let's see. Over the middle, that's caught. That's another first down and 17 yards. 24 seconds now. And again, a chance to throw to the end zone. No, it's going to be knocked away. So they took their shot, and now they will try a field goal. They get it, and it's 14-13 at half. Now getting the ball for the first time in the third quarter. And it's a Lando Lakes handoff. And again, Lando bouncing off of people, both teammates and opponents. And he's got 5 yards, 48 total on the ground. Now he's had some success catching the football as well, as he's a dual threat. Now he gets outside on the run, and he's got good yardage. He cuts inside, gets a few more, 24 yards in total on the run, his biggest of the day. And he now is up to 72 yards all of a sudden. Nice run right here. Nice blocking. And he makes number 7 miss there to get him at least 5 more yards. So on 1st and 10, a little bit of motion. And they're going to try to run off tackle again. And again, he's got fairly good success. He gets 5 yards. They'll take that every time. 2nd and 5, they want to throw. Lando blocking in the interior there. And they complete the pass for a 1st down, 16 yards. And there we go again, moving the chains. This eventually leads to 1st and goal. Lando trying to bounce it outside. Nope, nothing there. Loses a yard. Not going to get a touchdown on that play. But well, let's see if they give him another chance to call his number. 2nd and goal. There you go. Right up the gut, basically, and gets that touchdown. Nice blocking. Means he doesn't really have to do a whole lot here. But scamper on in. And Sanford's got the 19-14 lead. It looks like they will go for 2 here to try to make it a 21-14 score. So the 2-point conversion is knocked away. Washington denies that. And Stanford has the lead, but it's by 5. So Washington, in typical Washington fashion for this game, will go down and score. And it looks like they missed their 2-point conversion. So it's a 20-19 game. Latter stages of the 3rd quarter, we'd like to answer and get that lead back. There's going to be a run for 5 yards for Lando. He's got 85 now on the game. Handoff on 2nd and 5. Nope, bottled up there. He's only going to get 1. So Stanford facing 3rd and 4 would really like a conversion right here on 3rd down. The pass is going to be for a 1st down to the right sideline there. And it's Brandon Scott making the catch for 17 yards. 1st and 10, Stanford trying to come down the field here. 3rd quarter almost over. Off to the right-hand side, not much there, just 2 yards for Lando. They're starting to key on him now. He's got 88 yards, but they're going to make it difficult for him to get to 100 here as they're watching him like a hawk. Here they pass to him, though, out of the backfield. Makes a man miss again. Arm tackle's not going to work, and had he not juked inside, he might have scored right there. Realizing that in hindsight, thought I had to go around a guy. I think it would have been better trying to continue down the sideline and maybe beat everybody to the end zone. I don't know. I'm not sure. Maybe somebody had the angle. Anyway, it's a big gain one way or another. And Lando Lake's feeling good about that catch. Okay, 1st and 10. He gets the handoff. Might be winded, but he doesn't show it. Bowling forward for 8 yards. Lando Lakes. He now has 96 yards. And he's really close to that 100-yard mark, but he's not going to get it there. That looked like a horse collar. Holy smokes, he goes down. It's going to be 3rd and 2. Well, they convert on that, but now they got 3rd and goal. And Lando Lakes is open. Oh, my goodness. I don't know if that was a drop or if it was knocked on out of there, but they don't get it. They have to settle for a field goal and take the lead, but it's 22-20. They hold, and they've got the ball back. So the question is, why are we passing here? I don't know. But we are. We're passing. We should be worried about clock management here and running. But instead, every play that popped up, even the alternative plays where you can pick 3, were passes. I'm like, what are we doing? We should be running this out here. Luckily, we are moving the football 2nd and 3, and they'll get a 1st down here. So that's good. But what about taking time off the clock? Why are we throwing and risking incomplete passes and everything? Here's a pass to Lando Lakes on 3rd and 11. And there you go. He stops short. So there's about 2:13 to play, and we have a chance to get a field goal here, but seriously, we should have wasted more time off the clock here. Washington's only been forced to take 1 timeout so far. I don't know why we were so aggressive in getting down the field. I mean, if we get points, I guess it pays off, right? This kick will ensure that Washington has to go the distance of the field and get the touchdown. It's 25-20. Well, Washington goes the distance and gets the touchdown and leaves us with only 45 seconds left. I think our clock management could have been better. Now we're down 3, and we have to hustle down the field. Lando will make that catch. 8-yard reception. Timeout. We got 2 left. And now we got 3rd and 2. 3rd and 2 with 35 seconds left. Caught for a 1st down, but we got to hurry up. Another timeout. Just 1 remaining. A good chunk of yards is crucial right here. 1st and 10, 33 seconds. And the throw is going to be picked off. Washington makes the play on defense that's going to seal the game. Unfortunately, because of the turnover, we'll never have that chance at a game-tying field goal. Washington wins at home, and they beat number 23 Stanford by 3. The one that got away there. If we would have been able to punch in a touchdown on one of those drives instead of a field goal, it might have been a different story. Perhaps if we wouldn't have been so aggressive passing on one of our last drives there, we could have run out the clock a little more, and that might have been a different story. Anyway, he comes close to getting 100 yards both passing and rushing. Doesn't get either. 95 rushing and 92 receiving. But a nice game by Lando Lakes, but it comes in a loss and a frustrating one at that. So now Stanford's 1-1. We'll have to see where they drop in the polls, if any. Well, we fast forward, and yeah, they are no longer ranked. So coming up, we go from Washington now to Washington State. The Cougars are 0-3, and that's a home game for us. So yeah, we should be turning it around in that one. Come on back for more Lando Lakes Road to Glory. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!